अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मोहम्मद आसिफ एंड प्रेजेंटिंग द ऑनलाइन वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ विजुअल प्रोग्रामिंग। स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज वीक नंबर 2 एंड लेक्चर नंबर 2। इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव लर्न द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ सी शार्प प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज, आल्सो लर्न The syntax of C sharp language mean the basic syntax of the C sharp language. Also learn about the variables and the variable declaration and initialization of the variable. Inshallah, in today's lecture, we will be learning first the typecasting, which include the implicit casting and the explicit typecasting. Next, inshallah, we will learn the dynamic initialization of the variable and the operator used in C sharp, that are arithmetic operators, comparison operators, and logical operators. And at the end, we will be learning the syntax of if statements, which include if else statement, nested if else statement. Sometimes we can call it as a else if statements, and at the end, inshallah, we will be learning the switch statements. Let's start our today's lecture. First, we will learn what is typecasting. Typecasting means type conversion. It is a method of changing an entity from one data type to another data type. For example, converting string into integer data type or integer into string data type. There are two type of casting. Number one, implicit casting, and the second one is a explicit casting. What is implicit casting? Automatically. Mean this casting will be done automatically by the C sharp. We will discuss it in a next slide. But first, converting a smaller type to a larger type size. For example, character is a smaller data type. We can convert it into the integer. Integer can be converted to long, long into the float, and float can be converted to double. Mean the sizes will be going in a maximum smaller type to a larger type. What is explicit casting? Mean it will be done manually by the programmer. Converting a larger type to a smaller size type. For example, double is a larger type. Float is less in size than the double. So we can convert double into a float, and float into long, and long into integer, and then the character. Now let's see the example in which we will be converting a smaller size to a larger data type. For example, we have just declared a variable of integer type and initialize with a 9. Also declare a variable with a double data type and assign my integer, mean this is the integer variable. So we have just assigned this variable to the double variable. It means we are converting implicitly one data type to another data type. Automatic casting int into double. So when we print the integer variable, it will print 9. And when we print the double variable, again it will print 9. No difference in the values, but the size of these two variables must be different. So this is how implicit casting will be achieved. Next, the example of explicit casting means it will be done manually by the programmer, but from larger size to smaller size. So let's say we have a one variable of a double type and initialize with the 9.78. Next, we have a variable of integer type, and manually written within the parentheses. Now, this is the syntax that how to convert explicitly. So, within the parentheses, we have written the data type, and now converting the double into the integer manually. So, this is how we will be explicitly converting the larger size to the smaller data type. So, here assignment operator, the type in which you want to convert, and the variable or the data type variable which will be converted. So, manually casting double to integer. So, this is how we will be achieving from a double data type to integer data type. So, when first we printed a double variable, so it just printed 9.78, the original value. But if we print my integer value, so it just printed the new value, which is only the 9, except the real point, the floating point number, and also changes the size of these variables. So this is how explicitly the casting will be done. Now let's move towards the type conversion methods. It is also possible to convert data type explicitly by using built-in methods. For example, convert to boolean, to boolean, convert to double, convert to string, convert to int 32, convert to int 64. So these are the built-in methods. These are the built-in methods to which we will be converting one data type to explicitly to another data type. For example, we have a variable of integer type myInt initialized with a 10. We have a second data type myDouble and initialized with a 5.27. Third variable is bool of a bool data type, and the value is true. So, first we want to convert, so write line within the parenthesis, within this method, we are just sending or passing an argument that is convert.toString, because we are converting integer to string, integer to string. So we have just written convert.toString. ToString is a method which will convert integer to the string, float to string, double into string. So we have how to write toString again is a method. So within the parenthesis we are passing the integer variable, the integer variable. So we have just converted integer into the string. Next, write line convert dot to double. So it means we are converting the integer variable to a double data type. Next, we have a double variable and converting it to int 32, mean we are converting to integer, but the size will be almost 32 bits. Next, we have a bool data type. My bool is a variable of boolean data type. So we are converting this bool to string data type. So these are the four built-in methods which is used to convert one data type to another data type by using built-in methods. Next, that we will learn that how to take a value during a running time from the user. For example, if you want to take a value from a user as a string, so how it will be taken. So let's see. First, just print a message to the user console.WriteLine. WriteLine function is used to print any message or value. So within the parentheses, we have just write enter your name, yeah, username. So first we have declared a data type and a variable name, username, and assignment operator, because we are initializing the value, but not in the source code, but during running time. How to initialize during running time? We will be using the readLine function, the readLine function. But this line, readLine function, belongs to console class. So console.readLine. So this line will be written. So with the help of this statement, we will be just taking a value from a user and initialize and store, we can say it, store it in the user name. So we have just have taken a value from the user and store it in a user name. So readLine function will be used to take the value from a user during running time. Next, we want to print this value. So console.WriteLine and messages just printed, then concatenated, and write the name of the variable. So when we execute this code, so the message will be username is whatever you have entered will be printed. So how to take a value from a user during running time? With the help of readLine. Now we have just initialized a string value. The question is how to initialize the numbers, float number, integer numbers. So let's see. First, we will be printing a simple message, console.WriteLine, enter your age. So again, we have just declared a variable of integer data type and assignment operator. So we have just written and learned in our previous slide, console.readLine. So with the help of readLine, we will be initializing the value, and at the end we are just printing this variable. But when we execute this code, it will give us a simple error message, because and the message will be cannot implicitly convert type string to integer, because whenever you take a value from a user during running time, any value that is you are taking during running time will be considered as a string value, whether you have declared it as a string or integer or float or character. Whenever we will be entering any value, it should be 1, 2, 3, or A, B, C, or hello world, anything will be considered as a string within the C# compiler, within the CLR. So we will be converting that string value to our desired value. For example, in this situation, we need that value to be converted into the string data type, because we have just taken a value, but compiler taken it as a string value. We must have to convert this string value into the integer this time. So how to take? So here is the example. We will be again integer age assignment operator. We will be using convert dot to int 32. It means we are converting the value to integer from the value that we have taken during running time, which is a string. So now that value will be converted to integer and store it into the variable of integer type. We can also use another built-in function, which is called toParse function. Inshallah, in a later class we will be practicing on both of these built-in functions. So how to convert the string value into the integer? If next time we want to take a float value, So we will be writing convert dot a double r float, and within the parenthesis we will be writing read line. Next, what are the C sharp operators? Number one, arithmetic operators, which include plus, minus, multiply, divide, modulus, increment and decrement. So these are the operator, and this is how we will be using these operators, like in other programming languages. Comparison operators like equal, not equal, greater, less than, greater than, equal to, less than. So these are the comparison operators. Logical operators, and, or, and not operators, same like other programming languages like C++ and Java. So these were the C sharp operator. Next, the important topic is if statements. How the conditions will be checked? Number one, the simple if statement syntax is, if is a keyword, then the condition will be checked, and then the body of the if statement. So from the condition, it will give us a single result whether it should be true or false. So this is the syntax of if statement. Next, we have a if else statement. So if is a keyword, if the condition is true, then this body will be executed. If the condition is become false, then the else portion will be executed. So else again is a keyword. Next, we have a nested if else statement. Sometimes we call it as a else if statement. So we will be having more than one conditions, but only one block will be executed and rest of them will be skipped. So the syntax is, if the condition is true, then this block will be executed. If and the rest will be skipped. But if the condition becomes false, so the control goes to else if, mean on the second condition. If it is true, then the second block will be executed and the rest of them will be skipped. But if this condition is false, or all conditions which is given above is false, the last else statement will be executed. So this is how the nested if else statements. Next, we have a switch statement. Switch statement work like a nested if else statement, and the syntax of the switch statement is, first we will be having a keyword switch and the expression. Within the switch statement we will be having cases, case 1, case 2, and at the end by default. So if case 1 is true or matched, then this code will be executed, and break keyword will also be executed to skip rest of the cases. If first case is not matched with the expression or the condition, then second case will be checked, third case will be checked, fourth case. But if none of them is matched with the condition or the expression, then at the end by default, you can say it, default keyword will be executed, and each block there will be a break statement. Break statement is used to skip the rest of the blocks. So this is how the switch statement is. Inshallah, in our lab class we will be implementing all these syntax within the Visual Studio. So students, let's a quick recap of today's lecture. So first we have learned what is typecasting, implicitly, explicitly, and type conversion methods, and initialize variable during running time. We have also learned about the operators used in the C#, that is arithmetic, comparison operators, and logical operators. At the end, we have learned the syntax of if statement, which include if statement, if else statement, nested if else statement, and the switch statement. Students, this is enough for today's lecture. If you have any question regarding this lecture, you may ask me on my official email address, that is asif@northern.edu.pk. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.